You thought you were safe. So, it's time. Okay, today, boys and girls, we're gonna cut to the chase. We're talking about Mihawk. I'll be making the top 30 strongest One Piece characters on this channel within the coming week, and I'll be having a live stream on my other channel, Brago D Ace, this month, where me and a few friends, we talk about the strongest characters in One Piece. Now, where Mihawk will be, that's anyone's guess, but I was just letting you guys know because Mihawk is one of the most difficult characters to power scale, and that's just a fact. The difficult thing with power scaling is that people do it differently. Some people use facts and evidence from the real world, and they use, you know, equations and different things to justify things that happen in an anime or manga. I don't like taking that route because in every series, an author, mangaka, however you want to say it, they establish rules within the verse. Some rules are different to ours. And then also, we have to factor in the environment of these specific worlds. How does the speed of light impact a world like One Piece? I mean, the world is a lot larger than ours, so wouldn't that essentially make things a lot different? We talk about fire and magma, as far as magma being hotter than fire, and all these different things, we have to use the established rules. Another thing is portrayal. And that's somewhat subjective because one portrayal could be great to one person and to another, not that impressive. But that is a part of power scaling, especially in One Piece where we don't see a lot of fights. That brings us to feats, things that characters have actually done. And then combining all these things, you have to somewhat remain consistent with the story elements that have been presented. Got it? Yeah, I agree with you. It's not a consistent formula at all because it's largely subjective and that leads to contentious arguments or contentious comments like I'm an asshole because I think Rayleigh and Odin could be on par. And someone commented and it was funny because they said, people were mad that you were comparing fictional characters? How old are they? Five? And I liked it because that's true. People get mad at these things, but I understand people are invested. The first thing people think of with Mihawk, world's greatest swordsman, haven't really seen him go all out. Stop me if you've heard that before in One Piece. Shanks' rival, etc., etc. The Mihawk lore is strong, but people have wide ranges in regards to where they put him. It's funny because some people, they hate power scaling, like they can't stand it. However, they're always in a power scaling video comment. So, I think you actually like power scaling, you just don't want to admit it. So if you're here right now and you say you don't like power scaling, drop a like. Just drop a like. But back to it though. Let me break down my thought process with Mihawk. You guys can let me know how you feel about it, if you agree or disagree, but here I go. Mihawk is currently the world's greatest swordsman, world's strongest swordsman, world's best swordsman, however you want to put it. Damn, quick tangent. Mihawk and his comparison to swordsmen of the past, I'm not ready to have that conversation yet. I need more information because if I start speculating Mihawk in comparison to Odin, Rayleigh, Ryuma, it really leads nowhere because we don't even know how strong Mihawk is. So with that argument, we have nowhere to begin. So comparing them to characters, we don't even know how strong they were in their primes. It's all speculation at the end of the day. So I might just make a top 5 strongest swordsman ever. Back on task. Let's start with portrayal. From introduction, Mihawk has been portrayed as one of the strongest characters in One Piece. He was wildly impressive at Baratie. I mean, there was nobody that could really contend with him. Outside of Don Krieg and his diamond knuckles, there was nobody else. The most we've seen from Mihawk revolves around the most inconsistent power scaling arc in One Piece, Marineford, but that's why we love it. You can take any argument you want and mix it and flip it to work in your favor. There's a lot of good and some bad for Mihawk in Marineford. Mihawk and his dialogue to Whitebeard. This has been argued and speculated and just debated so many different ways because for some people, they feel like this is Mihawk testing himself. And they say, if you're testing yourself, that means that you don't think you're on that level. Therefore, Mihawk is weaker than Whitebeard. Therefore, Mihawk does not compare the Shanks. Boom. I wish power scaling was that easy. But let's dissect what Mihawk actually said and try to come to an agreement of what he was talking about. So when I'm trying to clarify certain things, I always refer to the Viz translations because those are official. People normally agree that, okay, if we're using the official, that's what we're gonna go with. There are several translations out there. At the end of the day, is somebody actually translating it? I think it's always safe to refer to the official. So in the official translation, the Viz official, Mihawk says, I just want to measure the true distance between that man and us. That could be spun two ways. One, Mihawk was testing himself. He's never matched up with someone on that level, on that tier, which is cap. So therefore, he wants to test his own mettle because we know Mihawk, he's traveled the world and he's tried to find strong people to test himself against. So this is another test for himself. Therefore, Mihawk is not on the Yonko's level. kind of cap, but the more I think about it, Another way to look at this, Mihawk, looking at Whitebeard, yeah, they say he's the strongest. I know how strong I am. Let me see if he really lives up to his reputation. Meaning he's not testing himself, he's testing if Whitebeard is really as strong as they say, or if the old legend had fallen off at all. See, it's like, it's so nuanced because those small things could completely change an argument. So for this particular instance, people use that for and against Mihawk. Next, the people Mihawk matched up against at Marineford. Mihawk fought Luffy. Mihawk is not going to kill Luffy. Luffy's the main character. Therefore, that entire matchup is null and void because Mihawk was fascinated with Luffy. You know his relationship with Shanks. There's a lot there. Too much personal stuff going on. I don't count that. That's just plot-driven narrative right there. We don't use that. Get it out of here. Next, Mihawk versus Buggy. That's one we really have to delve into. No, I'm joking. Let's move on. Mihawk versus Vista. Vista is not a scrub. Vista is shown in the flashback with Whitebeard. He's one of Whitebeard's first crewmates. An early crewmate of Whitebeard. Not, we don't know if he's one of the first because there were hella people there. But from what we've seen, Vista's been there for a while. And he's also a commander of the strongest man in the world. The strongest pirate in the world. Mihawk fought Vista. And at the end of it, kind of had to talk Vista down. Again, he specifically said, according to the Viz, we should settle this later, Vista. It seems that would benefit us both. One thing One Piece does really well is incorporating character traits into character interactions or certain character situations. What I mean is, One Piece doesn't just use because someone is stronger means that someone is going to overpower and win immediately. Personality and personality traits are factored in to somewhat make more sense of situations. For instance, Luffy. There's several situations in which Luffy should overpower his opponent, but Luffy at times he plays around, he's fun-loving, he's gullible, and he gets taken advantage of, i.e. Caesar. Caesar cannot compete with Luffy at all, but Caesar caught him off guard because that's generally how Luffy is. For Mihawk and Vista, I personally think duels are sacred for Mihawk, and he felt like Vista was a formidable opponent, and I guess he didn't want to, for lack of a better term, corrupt this duel when each person had different motives. Like, the motive was not to fight each other at the time. There was no honor and respect there. So Mihawk is saying, let's fight another time when we actually want to fight each other and an actual outcome would be honorable. That's how I'm looking at the situation. Another way is that Mihawk had to talk down a commander who we know cannot compete with any of the Yonko. If you're that strong, then you should immediately overpower Vista to get to your goal, or maybe, just maybe, you were not going as hard because you were trying to protect Luffy. There is something in there with Mihawk and Luffy in which he tells Luffy his blade knows no restraint, but again, I don't use that. We know Luffy, at the end of the day, had no chance against Mihawk at Marineford. No chance. Smoker tied him down. And that's no disrespect to my goat, Smoker, but I mean, Smoker tied him down. So, I mean, defeats for Mihawk cutting icebergs. I mean, his slash was stopped by Jozu, but then again, the breath of all things. We saw that in Alabasta, but it's not fleshed out that well. With Ryobi incorporated, I think if Marineford was like right now, a lot of things would be different. If hockey was as prevalent as it is now, Marineford would be a different shit show. Now let's go to the great debate. Mihawk and Shanks. Mihawk and Shanks had several duels that rang through the new world. Whitebeard said it himself. I'm not gonna touch, Mihawk is a swordsman, the world's greatest. Shanks is a swordsman, therefore Shanks is beneath Mihawk. I'm not gonna touch that at all. That's nasty. However, I'll say this. It's not as easy to use that as an argument because, one, rivalry does not mean equality. You can have a rivalry with someone, but still be getting your ass beat every single time. But it's a rivalry. Apparently, Moria was rivals with Kaido at one point. But people grow differently. Mihawk is the greatest swordsman in the world, so his potential is high. Shanks is now a Yonko, one of these four greatest pirates. Four strongest, however you want to twist it. I think for me, where the argument changed a lot was when we found out when Shanks became a Yonko. 6 years ago. Mihawk fought Shanks before he lost his arm. So therefore, Mihawk fought Shanks before he was officially a Yonko. Mihawk has not fought Shanks in a very, very long time. Mihawk at Marineford said that he doesn't want to fight Shanks. Now people are saying, well, you said that Mihawk holds his duel sacred, so therefore he does not want to fight Shanks with his arm. Yes, I agree. There's some sanctity to this. However, it's inconsistent, and I'm trying to have everything remain consistent. Not fighting someone for a long time, meaning the last time Mihawk fought Shanks was at least before Luffy was 7, and Shanks became a Yonko when Luffy was 13. That's a very long time. I don't know how you can accurately assess how strong someone is if you don't fight them. Oda stated that Shanks has not lost any power even though he has one arm. Headcanon time. Shanks, after losing his arm, of course, he was a great swordsman while dueling Mihawk, and we don't know who won, but Mihawk has the title now. After losing his arm, Shanks had to compensate for losing that arm, so therefore developed new techniques and new fighting styles to not have a loss in overall strength. We know Shanks was a named pirate because Whitebeard said after Shanks came back from East Blue, people were wondering who was strong enough to take Shanks' arm. To add more headcanon to it, I'm assuming Shanks was probably commander level at that point when he went to East Blue, at least. So yeah, that would raise some eyebrows. How do you know how strong Shanks is now, Mihawk? He could be a completely different person now. There are even more things coming out to support Mihawk, actually, in which Oda says he's waiting for someone stronger than his rival Shanks. How do you know how strong Shanks is? You won't fight him. I'll end it with this. Shanks could have been Yonko level before becoming a Yonko, so it's not definitive. Mihawk uses a sword, Shanks is a swordsman. Mihawk hasn't fought Shanks in a long time. We don't know if Mihawk has been Nuano. We don't know if Mihawk has fought Rayleigh. I say all this to say this. I really don't know where to put Mihawk. One thing I do know, though, is that he is at least top 10. For me, he's in my top 10. I don't take the world's greatest titles lightly. Right? Those are there for a reason. So in a nutshell, he's extremely difficult to power scale. You can put him anywhere from top 3 or 4 to top 12, 13, just based on the different arguments that you want to use. I'll end it with this. The common notion is that Mihawk is the goal that Zoro is trying to surpass. So therefore, Mihawk has to at least be Rayleigh, right? That has to be the peak, at least. Or at best, Rayleigh, because people, I don't want to touch the Rayleigh fans because goddamn, they're out there. Zoro has to surpass that to become the world's greatest swordsman. If he's Zoro's final goal, that's the case, for sure. But Mihawk isn't Zoro's final goal. Mihawk's title is. Yes, currently it's Mihawk, because he has the title. If Mihawk loses the title by the time Zoro is ready, someone else becomes the goal. Speculation that it's Shiryu. I don't know. I would love for it to be Mihawk. It makes more sense thematically, but we don't know. Speculation all around. So that's it for me. I hope I confused you more, because I definitely confused myself even more. Tune in to see where I put Mihawk in my top 10 or top 30, because it's really difficult. Does Mihawk beat Big Mom with Napoleon? He's a swordsman, right? What about Akiji? He uses an ice sword. Izaru? Shit is difficult, dude. But yeah, leave your thoughts below. Where do you put Mihawk? Like, how strong do you think he is? What are your thoughts in general? Because it's so many questions I could ask. Just give me your thoughts. Mihawk has a crazy fan club. Like, people love Mihawk. I love Mihawk. The drip is crazy, but I just don't know where to rank him, and I don't want to disrespect him, but you gotta tune into the top 30 to see. My other channel will be in the description box down below. Like the video if you did. Be sure to subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Shout out to my patrons. I love you guys. I appreciate it so much. The support goes a long way. Follow me on Twitter at BragoDAce. Follow me on Instagram at BragoD.Ace. Again, like, that helps a lot. Subscribe, that helps too. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.